Hello, and welcome to another quick lessons video with me, Jacob Woolcock. Today, I'm going to show you how to create your own sunrise and sunset animations using the Keynote app on your iPad. Here's an example of what we're going to try and make by the end of this quick lesson. Your scene can be however you imagine it to be, but the idea is going to be that the sun will come up, and then the sun will go down and reveal nighttime in that scene. To make this work, we're going to use Keynote, and we're going to create a new workspace that's ready to go. Then we're going to create a daytime version of our scene. I'm going to show you how to bring on objects and symbols, how to recolor, resize and rotate, and create a really lovely landscape. Then, in step number 3, we're going to add the magic move animation. We're then going to change our daytime scene to make it turn into nighttime by changing some of the colors and the layout. And then your animation will come to life before your very eyes. Lastly, in step number 5, we'll save this and export it as a movie that you can then share elsewhere. All you need to do this tutorial is an iPad with the Keynote app installed. You don't need a stylus or an Apple Pencil or anything like that, just an iPad and your imagination. Well, what are we waiting for? Let's jump straight in with step number 1. To begin with, let's open up the Keynote app, and from here we'll create a new blank presentation. Go onto the theme browser and just choose a plain white slide this time. When your presentation opens, you want to tap and drag your finger over those 3 text boxes and press delete, and that will leave you with a lovely blank workspace to begin. At this stage, it's worth giving your presentation a name. So tap at the top where it says presentation, and then type in something like day to night animation, something that you can find if you ever need to go back to this in the future. Now, when you've done that, I'd like you to press the plus button on the top right-hand side of your screen and have a look at the objects built into Keynote. Now, there are hundreds of different objects and symbols built in here, and I'd like you to take a moment or two to explore some of them so you can start to imagine how these could be used in your scene later on. Finally, for step number 1, we're going to change the background colour of our slide to a nice blue sky for a nice sunny day. So press on the Format paintbrush, go on to Slide Background, and then swipe across to get all of the different colour options, and from here I'm going to choose that lovely blue shade. Let's pause for a moment here while you have a look at the symbols in Keynote and change your background colour of your new slide. We'll move on when you're ready. So now it's time to start building out our scene to make it more than just a plain blue page. I'm going back to the plus button and onto the object browser, and I'm going to search for a cloud that I spotted earlier. When that cloud comes into Keynote, the colour probably won't be the colour you want it to be for a cloud, so tap onto the object, press the Format paintbrush, and you can recolour it from there. I'm going to go for a white or a very pale grey to make my cloud look really normal, and then I'm going to copy and paste it and resize them to put more than one cloud on my page. A great tip here is that you can flip objects left to right or up and down, and to do that you press the Format paintbrush, you go along to Arrange, and then you can flip horizontally or vertically. If I flip my cloud, it will make it slightly different from the other ones, and it looks a bit less like I've just copied and pasted the same cloud all over the place, even though I kind of have. It gives some variety along with the resizing and the positioning in the sky. Next, I want to add some ground at the bottom of my screen. So back on the Shape browser again, I'm going to search for Mountain this time. You haven't got to use a mountain, you can choose whatever you want for this scene, but I'll demo it with a mountain now. So when I bring that onto my page and I start to resize it, you'll notice that it gets wider at the same aspect ratio as it gets taller. In other words, it moves in proportion. I actually want to stretch this out sideways, but not make the mountains taller. To do this, I'm going to tap onto the Format paintbrush, go onto the Arrange tab, and here there's a toggle called Constrain Proportions. If I turn that off, I can then grab the side of the mountains and I can stretch them out nice and wide to fill that page. And at this point, they look a bit less like mountains and a bit more like some rugged hills in the background. Let's make them green, and then we're going to copy and paste them to make another row of hills behind that row. With my new hills, I'm going to make them a slightly darker shade of green. So I'll do that on the Format panel at the top. And then I'm going to go along to Arrange. And now I'm going to move the layer backwards one step on that ladder at the top. So drag the little marker one step to the left, and your background hills will now go behind the hills you had originally. I'll do that one more time by pasting those mountains, making a darker shade of green again, going onto the Format brush, arranging it so it goes behind the other 2 lots of hills, and then lining it up so you don't see obviously that it's the same symbol used 3 times. Now I've got that lovely depth effect, and I've got some clouds in the sky. I think it's time to add a sunshine. I'm going to repeat the same steps as before here, I won't go through them all again now for you, but when you add that symbol in, make sure you go to the Arrange tab on the Format panel and move it behind the clouds so it fits in naturally into the sky. Add in any other elements that you want here to build out your scene. The more you have, the better it will look. But also remember, sometimes less is more as well. So whatever works best for you. Okay, this is your time to explore and be creative. So build out an amazing daytime scene for me. Think about clouds, think about a sunshine, think about some ground. Off you go. Now we're getting to the kind of fun stuff with the animation. So tap onto the thumbnail of your slide on the left-hand side and tap onto transition. From here on that new toolbar, you want to add a transition and you're going to choose Magic Move. Now when you go on there and you come off of that screen, you'll get a little message that comes up asking you if you want to duplicate that slide. Tap on Duplicate and that will make a second version of your slide identical to the first one. I'll tell you why in a moment. We're now going to do exactly the same thing on that second slide. So tap onto there again and add another Magic Move transition. Once more, we're going to duplicate that slide. Okay, let's come out of animation mode and let's press play on that top toolbar and see what happens. And absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing has happened. But don't worry, that's exactly what's meant to happen. Confusing, eh? Well, let me explain. What the Magic Move transition does is it looks at the different objects on each page of your presentation, and it will then magically move the objects between them if they've changed. Now, because we've got three slides that are all exactly the same, nothing has changed, which means no movement is happening. But if I go onto that second slide and just move my son from one side of the screen to the other, and then go back and press play, watch what suddenly happens. That son moves from its position on slide number one to its new position on slide number two, and then back to its position on slide number three again at the end. We've now created an animation by doing absolutely no hard work, but now the fun can begin in step number four. Okay, I'll give you a few minutes to duplicate your slides and add the Magic Move transition, and when you're ready, we'll start step number four together. Let's go back onto slide number two now, which is going to become our nighttime scene. And to make it really apparent straight away that we're changing it, what we'll do is go onto the Format paintbrush and change our slide background colour to a much more kind of like nighttime blue. So a nice dark, rich navy blue perhaps. And now straight away we can see this is going to be our nighttime scene. Obviously at nighttime we don't need our sun in place, but let's drag that to the bottom of the screen, off the page even, underneath the mountains. That way when it animates it will rise up like a nice sunrise. So drag that right down to the bottom for me, and then we're going to move some of the clouds around as well. Make sure you zoomed out of your slide so you can see the empty space around your page, because that will come in handy. Now, relocate your clouds so they're off the screen completely. But when you're doing this, I want you to remember that they're going to slide between the places on the different slides. So don't move them down to the bottom of your screen, keep them on that same horizontal line, but move them to either the left or right side of your screen. The further off-screen you move them, the further they'll have to travel, which means the quicker they'll move in your animation later. So you can start to experiment and play around with this a little bit. You could even change the scale by changing the size of some clouds, so as they move on they get bigger or smaller. Now, at the moment our hills are quite a bright shade of green for nighttime, so let's tap onto them and make them all much, much darker. I'll go onto my colour mixer this time and bring the brightness slider right down, so each one is a much, much darker shade of green. It now starts to look a lot more like nighttime, which is great. Let's add a moon in. So add a new symbol, grab the moon, and put that where you want it on the screen. We'll make the moon a nice moony colour, whatever a moony colour is, I guess is a pale yellow. And then I'm going to add some stars in as well, using that same colour. With the stars, I'm going to make them teeny tiny on the screen by zooming right in and shrinking them down, and then I'll copy and paste them so they're all over the place. Now you can absolutely experiment here and really explore what Magic Move can do. Some things that you could potentially try include changing colours, changing the size, changing the position of objects, and rotating objects. Any of those changes will be animated automatically by Keynote, as long as the same object is on both of the slides. Now we've added the moon to slide number two, but that doesn't exist on slide one or slide three. So right now that's not going to animate. Let's fix that. Let's fix that by copying and pasting it onto slide 1 and slide 3. We don't want the moon in the sky in the daytime, so I'm going to move one to the left-hand side and one to the right-hand side. That way it will animate kind of going across the sky, which should look lovely. The stars on page number 2 are going to be okay, because if Keynote can't find a matching object on a different slide, it will gradually fade in those objects instead, which looks lovely for some nighttime stars. If I now go back to slide number one and press the play button in the toolbar, your animation will come to life and you should see your screen go from daytime to nighttime and back to daytime again. Take some time here to craft that nighttime scene and check how the animation looks before you move on to step number five. I'm here waiting when you're ready. Before we export our animation as a movie, I want to make a couple of changes to make the animation look better. So tap onto the first thumbnail of the first slide and go onto Transition. From here, tap onto Magic Move, and now you can change some properties. Firstly, I want my animation to last a bit longer so it looks more gradual. So I'm going to drag my duration to be about 8 or 10 seconds. Secondly, where it says acceleration, I'm going to tap onto there and choose none, so the animation happens at a constant speed. Tap off of here completely, go onto slide number 2, go onto the transition, go onto magic move, and make those same adjustments there too. Change the duration to make it longer, and choose the acceleration to be none. Now when I press the play button, the animation will take a little bit longer, and it will be smoother as well, which makes it look more natural. I think that looks great. When you're happy and you've finished tweaking your different scenes, it's time to press the three dots in the top corner, go down to Export and choose Movie. On this page, you've got a few settings to choose, as always. I'm going to make sure the animations happen after a 0 second delay, so it all plays automatically, and I'm going to press Export. The final step is to save that movie, and now when I go into the Photos app, my film should be there ready to play and ready to share. Alright, well done for getting this far, for following all five steps, and hopefully now you're going to have some time to finish off your animations. We've learned all about Magic Move today, we've learned about how you can transition between objects in Keynote, and what properties you can change to make that animation look really spectacular. I hope you've had fun making this. If you've enjoyed that and you want to take your Keynote work to a whole nother level, I'd really suggest checking out this video from my friend Ben Hayden. He is amazing in Keynote, and some of the scenes he builds will really inspire you. Of course, you can build your own scene in his style and then animate it using Magic Move as well. As always, I would love to see what you've made, so if you're able to, please do share on Twitter or Instagram using the hashtag QuickLessons, or find me and tag me in it as well. And if you want some more quick lessons, do check out the other videos on the screen now, or subscribe to my channel where there are loads more quick lessons and iPad tips just waiting for you over there. Until next time, take care.